بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
You know about Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu. How did he become a Muslim? Right? How did Umar ibn become a Muslim? What's the story? Who was responsible? His sister, right? Everybody knows that. But do you know that the seeds of that were planted before that? Through the Quran directly? The Quran was a mu'jiza. The Quran was the inimitable miracle for the Arabs at the time. Why? Because they were all into good Arabic writing. And the Quran was the best of it. And the professionals among them could recognize that this is not a human endeavor. This is beyond the human. This is divine. One day, Umar radiallahu anhu, before he became Muslim, I'm not sure if Rasulullah had already made dua for him or not. Because really, one of the main reasons that the Prophet made dua, oh Allah, support this deen, strengthen this deen with one of these two individuals, Amr ibn Hisham or Umar ibn al-Khattab. Amr ibn Hisham is Abu Jahl. So he wasn't accepted. Umar ibn al-Khattab was accepted. So one night he couldn't spend his night at home. Maybe he had some problem with whoever it was or whatever the case is. He couldn't spend his time at night. So he decided to go to the Kaaba, the house of Allah. So when he got there, the Prophet ﷺ, this was in the early days, the Prophet ﷺ used to go there and recite Salat, and recite Quran in Salat. So when he went there, he didn't like Muhammad ﷺ at the time. He went and hid behind the cloth of the Kaaba. Right? You know, they have that cloth. So it's been a tradition from before. He went and hid behind there. And the Prophet ﷺ is reciting in Salat. He started reciting Al-Haqqatu Mal-Haqqah وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَالْحَاقَّةِ. The surah Al-Haqqah, Al-Haqqah means the thing that is inevitable, the day of judgment. Al-Haqqah, Mal-Haqqah, do you know what the Haqqah is? Do you know what this inevitable event is? وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَالْحَاقَّةِ. What do you know? Do you know what it is, what it's about? So, Umar radiallahu anhu was hiding. Arch enemy, doesn't like Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but he was mesmerized by the Quran. Suddenly, he just couldn't help it, and he said to himself, "Hatha wallahi sha'ir." This man has to be a poet. Nobody else can speak like this. Now, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam continued reciting the surah. Towards the end of this surah, it says, "Innahu laqawlu rasulin kareem, wama huwa biqawli sha'ir, qalilan ma tu'minun." As soon as Umar radiallahu anhu said this statement in his mind, the Prophet ﷺ read this verse. This, إِنَّهُ لَقَوْلُ رَسُولٍ كَرِيمٍ. This is the words of a noble messenger. وَمَا هُوَ بِقَوْلِ شَاعِرٍ. It is not the words of a poet. قَلِيلًا مَا تُؤْمِنُونَ. So little do you believe. So then he thought to himself, immediately, if he's not a sha'ir, then بَلْ هُوَ كَاهِنٍ. He must be a soothsayer. And immediately the next verses, the Prophet ﷺ started reading, وَلَا بِقَوْلِ كَاهِنْ قَلِيلًا مَّا تَذَكَّرُونَ. Neither is he a soothsayer. So little do you reflect. That's it. The seeds had been planted in his heart. It was overcoming, it was overwhelming for him. The seeds had been planted. But it takes a while for a person to deal with the intellectual and emotional factors that you've been believing for all your life. The belief in something takes a while to course through your hearts and eventually envelope you. You have to deal with what your fathers used to believe in, what your community believes in, what your tradition, what your friends believe in. So sometimes the truth hits the heart, but it takes a while for it to infuse us. And I'm sure we've all dealt with it sometimes. Slowly, slowly it happens. That is what they say is the seed of faith was planted in Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, and then it needed his sister afterwards, and the blood and the violence that, and he's feeling sorry for her. That's it. And then he changed his faith. And this ummah has become greatly honored by his endeavors. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with him and bless him.